I'm Addie Krillis.
And I'm Kayla Macon.
And you're watching Fast Forward News. We hope the month of April is off to a great start for you all.
Absolutely. It is hard to believe that we are through our third week of spring and the semester, but today is indeed Friday, April 8th.
Keely, did you know today, April 8th, is National All Is Ours Day?
I didn't know that, Addie. What is National All Is Ours Day?
Good question, Keely. Every year this day, April 8th, is a day devoted to appreciating all the things of beauty around us.
I love that, Addie. How are we supposed to observe National All Is Ours Day?
The first way is by reflecting on all the good things in life that are open to everyone and then enjoying them.
You mean like beauty in nature?
Yes, that's exactly right. The second way the day can be observed is by reflecting on all the good things in life that are enjoyed by you personally.
So far, we could reflect and be thankful for our friends, family, and even our possessions, right?
Absolutely. Finally, the day can be observed by sharing the things you have with others, by taking the idea that it all is ours literally.
Do you mean like sharing the Oreos I brought for lunch with others?
That would be a great idea, Keely.
Well, I don't think that's going to happen. But today, on National All Is Ours Day, I will be sure to notice and reflect on the beautiful things around me and be thankful for them.
That's the spirit, Keely.
Guys, welcome to our 23rd edition of Fast Forward News.
That's right. As we've said, today is Friday, April 8th, and we have some really good things coming your way.
Our tennis, track, golf, baseball, and softball teams are starting competition next week.
After reaching out to our sports team coaches about preseason preparations, many got back with us about how the season is looking.
Here to report on our Wooden Spring Sports are our sportscast team of Morgan, Kinsey, Jazzy, Dalen, and Lily.
Take it away.
Kelly and Addie, I'm Morgan Harris, and with me is Kenzie Russell, Jazzy Easley, Cole Van Zandt, and Lily Adams.
It is truly hard to believe that our Wooden Spring Sports season is already here, but it is.
We would like to start by taking this opportunity to showcase our spring athletes and teams before they catapult into action next week.
We'll start with our baseball team. Showing out our 7th and 8th grade guys who start action next week on Wednesday against Edward.
First baseman Gavin Long says, I have been so excited for this season because it is the first year of middle school baseball here at Wooden. I feel like we have a very put together group and we will win games as long as we pay attention.
But speaking of our baseball teams, Coach Lindsay says, and I quote, our goal for this season is to get better every day, work hard, and win. We have a good group of young men and we can hit the field ball. If they put in effort and practice, they'll put themselves in a position to win every day.
This is our winning 7th and 8th grade track team. It starts next Tuesday in Bloomington against Bachelor Middle School.
Coach Beltran says, and I quote, we are ready to roll. We have a really strong team this year, and we have been motivating and challenging our athletes from day one.
Coach Beltran is excited and says our athletes have all shown up to work hard and are putting themselves out there and they're out of their comfort zone.
Now we are 7th and 8th grade softball teams. These two teams also take to the fields next Monday against Bloomfield.
8th grade shortstop Alway Scholl is super excited about the upcoming season and says simply, we do it better.
This is our Wooden golf team who takes to the greens against Center Grove next Thursday.
Coach Carter says to his team, and I quote, the next shot will be the best shot.
And last but absolutely not least of our spring sports teams and our Wooden Girls Tennis team. This team takes to the court for competitions on Monday against Brown County.
In courting, Minnesota, tennis is mainly mingling. Get out there, girls, and win those matches before they even start.
That's a wrap for our Wooden Spring Sports preview. We will begin our coverage next week, bringing you stats, footage, and updates as our team goes for the win.
Please make plans to show out and support your spring team.
Go Aggies!
Let's now take a moment to celebrate our Wooden family birthday.
Happy birthday, everyone! Happy birthday!
And I'm Quentin Sparenbrink.
And we're going to share with you
news from the office. We have quite a bit to share with you today. We would like to start out by congratulating our academic Super Bowl team for their outstanding performance on Tuesday evening.
Quinn, let's explain exactly what the academic Super Bowl is.
Good idea. Academic Super Bowl is a competition run by Purdue in which multiple schools across this whole state compete in a quiz over each core subject.
Core subjects include social studies, math, English, and science.
That's right. The team traveled to Plainfield Community Middle School for their 2022 Junior Academic Super Bowl.
Competing on this team this year were 16 students, made up with 7th graders and 8th graders.
Coaches for our winning team are Mr. Denning, Ms. Beltran, Ms. Cushing, and Ms. Crismore.
Our team of 16 students have been preparing for April competitions since November.
The team meets once a week to review resources and practice problem solving.
Results of Tuesday's competition were: Wooden scored first overall in social studies, third in math, fourth in science, and fourth in English.
The team scored second overall, and scores will be recalculated when the teammates compete again on April 30th.
On to other news. Are you going to Urban Air, Quinn?
Absolutely. Who wouldn't want to miss a day of school?
My sentiments exactly.
Here to pump us up about it are Hans and Franz.
Are you overworked?
It's all dirty.
Stressed out.
Do you need some friends time? Maybe more you time?
Get their schoolwork, but the students who do go will not have anything to make up. Oh my god! This is awesome!
Go.
We're going to Urban Air! We're going to Urban
Air!
Everyone, get your package still. Join us for the fun! Yeah! A whole day of no school? Just.
Thanks, Hans and Franz, for that Urban Air pump up.
Get your permission slips turned in.
Next up, we have Kiara and Cadence sharing with us some spectacular news and a whole lot of money that was raised last weekend for a couple of our winning students.
That's right. This group called Porch Time held a fundraiser. Emma, what is Porch Time and what is exactly going on?
Here to tell us about it is Kiara and Cadence.
Take it away, guys.
Hey guys, I'm Cadence Tinsley.
And I'm Karen Hardy. We have some incredible news of charity to share with you.
That's right. Kara, have you heard of Porch Time?
I have, Cadence, but I'm not really sure exactly what it is.
Gotcha. Porch Time is a family-friendly Facebook group where anyone is welcome. They discuss a lot of local news and subjects such as events, fundraisers, good deeds, crime, recipes, and fun activities.
Oh, okay. Sounds like a great group.
Yeah. They strive to keep our community informed and supported.
Oh, last Thursday, Porch Time contacted our very own Miss Long. They explained to us that they wanted to do a fundraiser to help offset travel expenses for our students who are traveling in June for national competitions.
And 2 days later, on Sunday, April 3rd, Porch Time pulled off a super successful charitable event that raised over $8,000.
That's right, Kaden. The fundraiser was to celebrate and support. Landon Houston will be traveling to New York City this June to perform at Carnegie Hall. And Aaron Pauly, who will be traveling to Scripps National Spelling Bee Competition in Washington, D.C. this June.
This is truly such a kind deed from Porch Time and another example of how this great community supports all of us here at Wooden.
Once again, congratulations, Landon and Aaron. And
thank you, Porch Time. Back to you, Emma and Quinn.
Thanks, Kieran Kins. Quinn, did you know that our Wooden Talent Show is a week away?
What? Are you serious? I thought it was at the end of the school year.
I know, right? Can you believe that we only have 6 weeks and 4 days left of school?
Wow! That's incredible.
Let's turn it over to Audie, who actually interviewed a talent show participant.
Go, Audie!
Good morning, I'm Audie Taylor, and with me is...
Logan Elliott.
I understand that next week is our Wooden Talent Show, and you will be performing in it. Can you tell us about the different acts that are going to be in the talent show?
Okay, so first, the talent show is going to be next week on Wednesday. It starts at 6:30. It is $3. Children 5 and under get in free. I am doing a bluegrass song. It was originally recorded in the 1940s, but it was re-recorded in around the 1990s, 1980s. And so I'm doing that song, and other people are doing singing acts. I know one person is playing on guitar. There's just a lot of good acts, a lot of good people, good voices are singing. So if you guys really want to come out, it'd really be good. It's going to be exciting, it's going to be fun, and it's going to be a night to remember.
So is this a competition or are you just showcasing?
Yes, it is a competition. The top three get awards, then the rest get medals.
Well, we hope to see a lot of people there.
Come, please come. It's going to be exciting. It's really fun, actually. It really is.
Thanks, Audie and Logan, for the preview of next Wednesday's talent show.
Guys, that's all we got for this from the office. We have for you this week.
Stay tuned for the next minute or so as we have prepared a collage of photos from Wednesday's mixer for you to enjoy.
Have a great day and an especially great weekend, guys.
See you next week!